I see all this potential. I see Swan. God damn it, an entire generation pumping gas, waiting tables, slaves with white collars. Advertising has us chasing cars and clothes, working jobs we hate so we can buy shit we don't need.
So awesome. He's always looking out for you. He'll show up for you. Whatever you need, he'll take care of you.
He's an amazing guy. Very, very interesting guy. Very intense.
And so you can't find anyone, but I'm like, you're a fucking asshole, dude. You're an asshole. You murdered yourself. You murdered yourself. You killed someone. That person happened to be you, but you couldn't even show up for yourself. I'm sorry.
Hello, handsome. What a day, eh? You look lonely.
Suicide or anything like that in the past? Okay. Is there anything I can do to help you?
I'll give you a hug.
I'll give you a hug. Seems like you got a lot going on, man. It's all right.
It's all right, man. It seems like a lot to take on, you know?
Dude, we can give you some.
You're one in a million, you know? I mean, you're actually sitting down and talking to me, you know? Most people don't give a damn. But it's all right. You know, when it comes down to it, I came in this world by myself, and when I die, I'm going to be the only one in that coffin. And so really all I guess that matters is me, I guess. I don't know. I think people matter, but the more I'm starting to see, less and less.
You matter, bro.
I feel that way about you, too. I mean, you care. It's sad to see that most people don't.
Stars, but we won't. We're slowly learning that fact. We're very, very pissed off.
Yeah. I'm sorry, I'm getting
it's okay,
real.
Man. Fucking... Listen, I get it. You love the guy, I loved him too. I've known many people that have killed themselves now. It's a very sad thing. That you can never fix. That sadness is always going to be a part of you. You're always going to think, maybe I could have gotten to him, maybe I could have talked to him, maybe if I was there.
But that was it. He did it. He reached out. He's like, I relate to you, Dave. I connect with you.
Wrap it up. I don't want to, but I have to. I want to ask you just quickly, the film director Olivia Wilde has a new movie out, which she says is based on you, this insane man, this pseudo-intellectual hero to the incel community. Incel being these weirdo loner men who are despicable in many ways. Is that you? Are you the intellectual hero to these people?
Sure. Why not? You know, people have been after me for a long time because I've been speaking to disaffected young men. Now, what a terrible thing to do that is. I thought the marginalized were supposed to have a voice.
It's making you emotional talking about
that. Well, God, you know. It's very difficult to understand how demoralized people are.
Marsh, why don't you get out? Get out of the house.
Did you love me? Ever?
Go. I said go, go.
Dad, did you love me or not? Daddy, I gotta know. Come on, lie to me and tell me you did. Let me feel like the piece of shit I am. Did you love me or not? Answer me!
Father always...
Not a father, you!
But that's what I do. I got to admit, I got to have to say, I need help. Dude, I don't want to need help. I don't want to need help. I want to know you, you know, because somewhere inside of me, you can't help me. I help me. I don't want to need help. I don't need you. That's what it was. That's what it is. Somewhere a long time ago, I needed somebody and they didn't do it.
And you are gone for good.
Why am I so sad? Am I doing the wrong thing?
Absolutely not.
The purpose never leaves us, because the very purpose is you. You are always the purpose. There may be another purpose, like being a SEAL or going to college or whatever, but the main purpose in life is you. So if you wake up in the morning and you don't want to do something, you don't care enough about yourself. And that's what you need to really research is, man, why am I not doing this for myself? Because that is the number one purpose in life, is to better oneself. So that's the only purpose I fucking need.
Butters?
Oh. Hey, Stan.
What's the matter with you?
Well, my girlfriend broke up with me.
Did she step on your heart with stiletto shoes?
Yeah. Sure does hurt.
So when you were telling me that you were doing bad and it wasn't, you weren't feeling good, and you were telling me you were suicidal, I was like, okay, stop. We're gonna figure this out. You know, I don't know what to do.
Yeah.
We're gonna figure this out. It made me nervous. Because I was nervous that I wasn't gonna be there when you needed me to be there. And you know, and you I would just
I would just get the call.
Just get the call. Yeah.
I mean, as a friend, that's the last thing you want to do is have some situation where you feel like maybe you could have called them and you could have made them feel better and they would have just gotten over that hump.
Yeah.
And then they would have been okay. Like, you became okay, man. I mean, you were my most depressed friend, and now you're probably one of my happiest friends.
No thanks. I love life. Huh? But you just got dumped. Well, yeah, and I'm sad. But at the same time, I'm really happy that something can make me feel that sad. It's like, it makes me feel alive, you know? It makes me feel human. The only way I can feel this sad now is if I felt something really good before. So I have to take the bad with the good. So I guess what I'm feeling is like a beautiful sadness. I guess that sounds stupid.
Yeah. No. No, Butters, that doesn't sound stupid at all.
Right.
I'm going to tell you how you can help yourself get through the times that suck. Real life. This is real life. 90% of your life will suck. 10% will be fucking happy. You may be a lucky guy and have a lot of fucking money, have a great ass woman, all this shit. Trust me. One-on-one with that fucking guy, he's missing something. His life still sucks because he hasn't faced something that bothered him his whole fucking life. Something is still eating that motherfucker up.
Almost everybody.
Everybody. Eating you the fuck up. But maybe you found a good way, how I did growing up, on how to ignore that voice that's saying, you ain't facing some shit. Period, man. I'm not special. I just stopped listening. I listened to that voice. This is why I talk so fucking aggressive. People say, man, do you believe in God? You cuss so much. When I say fuck, it's letting you know what I'm thinking. If I try to make it all pretty and shit, that's not what my life was. It was a violent, violent struggle daily to get where I'm at today. I'm not gonna water it down. I'm not gonna water it down. Shit wasn't fun.
The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, now go out and get what you're worth. But you gotta be willing to take the hits.
Good.
And as much fun.
Yeah, you had a bit of a good time, mate. Yeah, well, that's what life's about, isn't it? That's what life's about, mate. Just getting out there, having fun, you know, following your passion and just being enthusiastic, you know? That's the go.
No, I just realized, like, life is short. I'm going to die.
That's, again, trite, right?
Trite.
In many ways.
Yeah, well, Confucius had a great saying that, you know, every man has two lives. And the second starts when he realizes he has just one.
Wow. Go All the Way by Charles Bukowski. If you're going to try, go all the way. Otherwise, don't even start. If you're going to try, go all the way. This could mean losing girlfriends, wives, relatives, jobs, and maybe your mind. Go all the way.
Wait, did someone give some subs? Bro, you didn't have to. Can I give that money back? Kia ora. Is there any way I can give their money back? Oh, you too, and
across the country, teaching this fantastic Methodist, people continually say, I can't draw a straight line. I don't have the talent, Bob, to do what you're doing. That's baloney. Talent is a pursued interest. In other words, anything that you're willing to practice, you can do. And this is no exception.
People go into the gym. Do you know how many lives just going to the gym and lifting some weights has been saved? How many lives have been saved from just going to the gym and lifting weights? It seems so simple. The reason why it's so significant isn't just because of, you know, the effect of building muscle or whatever. It's because of what it does in terms of giving you hope. Because when you go to the gym somewhat consistently, soon enough, you totally believe that a week from now, you're going to be more muscular and more stronger. A month from now, you're going to be even more muscular and stronger. A year from now, you're going to look so good. You're going to feel so amazing. That's what gives us hope. On the other hand, what strips away hope is instant gratification activities. Video games, porn, Netflix, anime, junk food, drugs. Every time we do that, we can see into the future and see that our life will get worse. Every single time that we play video games, that we waste time doing anything, you know, don't even need me to like to tell you what it is. You know what is a time-wasting activity and what is a good, healthy activity.
It means more to me than anything I've ever received in my entire life. I'd like to thank my grandfather, Sergeant Jack Gardner, who is now deceased. This would be the happiest day of his entire life. I'd like to thank my mom up here, who...
I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you because I know how hard it is to take care of ourselves.
Once again, I'm telling you, you don't have to sub. Like, you don't have to. You can watch the stuff for free. Like, that's the best thing you can do. But please, hold on to your... Oh, I'm not a sub trainee, mate. Can you, like, hold on to your fella's money in the midst of a lockdown? Use it on your family, not me.
I think the reality is that, excuse me, I think the reality is that a lot of us feel so inadequate. We feel so alone in the things that we do. That when we try to reach out, people don't seem to understand what we're going through. I just don't want to try to understand. Most of the time they just go, oh, I hope you've been doing well. I hope you're okay. And what else can you answer? But yeah, I'm fine. And you don't want to let them be worried. I think that's the first obstacle to asking for help. And... and subsequently, we got to understand ourselves. Why are we asking for help? Is it an external thing that's putting pressure on us? Is it an internal thing that's affecting our heart, our mind, our soul? I think that's an important distinction to know, to understand. And especially if you don't have people around you that... know how to talk to you, know how to understand you. That's why I think having at least a best friend would help. Someone to talk to, someone to just lay it out, someone you can say that you love them, that they mean the world to you. And if it's not your family, just get one friend, one brother, one sister that's not bound by blood. And being able to tell them that. Because at the end of the day, connection has to go deep right into the root. Because if you don't do a deep connection, then you're screwed. That friendship, that relationship, it's not going to be strong. One single storm comes and it blows it over. It blows it apart. It takes it apart. And yeah, and I know it's hard. Even if you have friends around you and you have a loving family, sometimes the heart can't help but feel lonely. Sometimes the mind can't help but continue to lie to you that you're all alone, no one loves you, you're not wanted, you're not good enough. But I'm telling you, your mind lies to you as much as the forces of evil lie to you. Because that's just how bad our heart is. It doesn't want to tell you truths. It just wants to continually lie to you so you feel like shit. You feel like you're not going to be able to do anything. That you're not going to be able to work up to anything. And when you believe those lies, then that's when you don't do anything. That's when you just succumb and say, you know what, maybe I am a piece of shit. But you're not. You're really not. Just like what Tio said, I'm proud of you. We need to be proud of ourselves. And whatever goals and dreams we have, make sure you are the ultimate goal. Because how you care for yourself reflects on how you care for others. And you know, Jesus in the Bible said, do unto others what you want others to do unto you. And that's the first step of loving yourself. That is to love others. And if people don't reciprocate that love, then it's fine. You've tried. You've moved on. You gotta move on from that. And yeah. So this video has been great. I know I didn't say anything throughout the reaction because I didn't want to interrupt anything, but it's just my two cents after, you know, Hopecore. There's something going on in the lives of men where we seek out videos like this. It's not because we want to stay lonely. It's not because we want to stay sad. It's not because we want to stay in our feelings. It's just looking for someone to relate to. And seeing all these people, these big names, that they go through the same things that we do. I think that puts things into perspective. I think that makes us feel better. I think that gives us exactly what the video talks about, hope, in its core. But yeah, there are some truths in that video. Some absolutely horrifying truths that we need to face as men, as humans. And we need to come out stronger. If not for ourselves, for our families, for our friends. For that one person that cares for us. And if you feel that no one cares for you, well, I do. I care for you. God cares for you. God bless.